And welcome back to a new video. Today I'm in the Cupra and I want to show you the new multimedia system 2021 from Cupra, and I will go into detail a little bit and I try to show you every single detail. I will show you the cockpit and also I will show you the multimedia system. So first of all, we will start with the cockpit. And I want to tell you something. Seat and Cupra these days make some amazing multimedia system, and that's why I want to show you. In terms of visibility, the position of driver, it's perfect. You have a great visibility to the multimedia system, so you can see it's directed to the driver's side, and also you have a great visibility on the cockpit. So from this point of view, it's awesome, and also this multimedia system, it's one of the best on the market today, and you will see in a moment why I said that. Now the controllers are right here on the steering wheel, guys, so keep in mind that from here you control with those wheels here, you control all the settings right there on the cockpit. And if you go to the view, you can choose the different views there. You will see it in the moment. I will also zoom in a little bit on the cockpit so you can make an idea a little bit later. From here you change also the position of the things on the left and right side, so you can see right there you can change on the left and you can change also on the right side the different functions. So it is super, super impressive. Then you can customize in many ways. So let me zoom in now and let me show you how many ways to customize this cockpit are. So for example, you can have this view. Here it's one of the sport view, one of my favorite view. And you can have, for example, in the middle, wherever you want to have. You can have on the right side, wherever you want to have. So you can see there I change different functions, and also on the other side the same story, you can change and you can see the consumption, you can see the adaptive cruise control, you can see the range, and even in the middle you can change what you would like to see in the middle. I will not go too much into details, so I think you just make an idea. Then here on the adaptive cruise control and driving assistance, you can see that you can also customize in every single view, I can call it like that, you can adjust and change what you would like to see in the middle there. And also from here you can change different safety features, and you can customize the way you want it. So yeah, I guess you make already an idea. Then if you go here, you have also the same story going forward. On this screen here is much more interesting if you want to have it some kind of sporty driving mode. When you see only the tachometer, you have the G meter right now on the right side, and yeah, you can customize the way you want it. That's the great part, that you can customize and you can see wherever you want right there on the cockpit. So that's why I said this is one of the best on the market today, and it's kind of one of my favorite cockpit right now on the market. So yeah, I think you make an idea already. Let's go to the multimedia system. I have a huge screen here. It's like a tablet, to be honest. It's like a screen, like a TV screen. I think you can see even movies on it because it's very, very big. You don't have so many physical buttons like in other cars to control it. So you will have to control it totally with touchscreen. I try to make a good job. Sometimes the camera doesn't want to focus so well on the screen, but I try to go first time with first thing. Up here you will have different information like temperature, like climatic system, like seat, heating seats. All you have to do is just press that button and then you can heat your seat in no time. Here it has a nice graphic, nice resolution. I love the graphic and the resolution of this screen, and I like also the software. It's very responsive, very nice. Also from auto you can turn on and off the AC very fast, and you can choose also the position. You can go here on this vent in the middle, press the vent and it will get you directly to the climatic system option. Also you have heated steering wheel, you can see the button right there, and also on the right side you will see different function for defrosting the windows. Then here on the AC, guys, I will turn it off for the moment. here you have here on the right side, you have the rear, you can activate also from the rear, e-climatic. This is intelligent climatic, so warm my hand, cool my feet, defrost the window and stuff like that. You can also press those directly and it will do whatever it say there. Then you have this air care clima, where you have the air a little bit more fresher inside the car. And then you have the setting, so you can activate and you can set the way you want it, the climatic system. It's very complex, it's very nice, and it's simple. Once you learn it, it's simple. Even if it looks a little bit complicated in the beginning, it's a simple system. Now down here you have all the shortcuts button, kind of the shortcuts button. Then you press this navigation, it will get you directly to the navigation. You have a huge screen here. The navigation work pretty well, to be honest, and you have a very, very good responsive screen here. You can see it is super, super responsive, and it responds to the touch really, really easy. It has a 3D map here. For example, if you want to choose this destination, you press start, it gives you directly the address there. You can see how fast it's loading, and you can see the map also right there on the head-up display on the cockpit, and you can have it also here on the multimedia system. So it is amazing. You have here the route, you can change the different settings, for example, from here to the destination, to the map and stuff like that. I don't want to go too much into detail. Also here, it's a very complex system. Also here, for example, you press this, you choose day and night, the sound and whatever settings you want to choose. Now going forward, then you have the media here. You press this media button and then it gets you directly here. You have the Bluetooth, you have My Media, you have the source here. You can choose the USB as a source multimedia system, then radio, and then you have the settings down here. On the media settings. Now go to the phone here. You can connect your phone, of course. You can connect your phone so you can talk on the phone. Then you have Android Auto, Apple CarPlay, Mirror Link. You can mirror your phone super, super easy. And that's a great thing. But you have to use your USB cable to be able to see the Android Auto and Apple CarPlay, and you can use your application. Now here you have all the information about the car, the consumption, long term, short term, since fuel, status of the car here, tire pressure, service and whatever. And then going forward, you have the sound, because the car comes with Beat sound system. You have an amazing sound, and here you can customize so many things, guys, so many things in terms of sound. It has an amazing sound, the balance, the sound focus and the surround. So great sound system. Then this is kind of the main button here. You press this button here in the corner and it gets you to the home screen. This is the home screen, guys. On the home screen you have the radio in the middle, you have the navigation on the left side, and then you have the telephone on the right side. Also, of course, you can change those and you can customize the way you want it. Also, you go up and down and you can change this, so you can see how cool is that. Also you have the navigation and information about the navigation. It's super complex. And in the other side, the same story. Now press one more time on this one here and it gets you to the main menu. This is the main menu where you will find all the same settings that we see before, plus other settings extra. All of this we already see it, only the vehicle here we didn't see it yet. And here on the vehicle, it depends on the which safety feature come with the vehicle. You have the parking assist, the parking distance control, because the car come with a reverse camera. Of course, you can see it right here, which car will come with reverse camera and also with assistant on the parking. Then you have the traction control, hill descendant control. Here you can activate, deactivate, start stop system, lane assist. Going on the right side, you have adaptive cruise control, dynamic road sign display, eco assist, driving alert system, side assist and front assist, and all kind of safety emergency settings that come from Cupra and Seat. They are here. Amazing. Those safety settings these days are just phenomenal. Now we were to the driving assist, drive profile. On the driver profile you have different driving modes: sport, Cupra mode, and off-road mode. So from here you can change different types of driving, depend how you like to drive. It's changed also the suspension, the responsive, how responsive is the steering wheel, how responsive are suspension, and how responsive its acceleration, depend on which you choose here. Background lighting. This is the background lighting. From here you can change different light, the way you want to have it inside the car. So every time you change this background light, guys, it's changed also the ambient light inside the car, because the car come with ambient light. And all these new Cupras, almost, yeah, I think all the Cupra these days come with ambient light, so you can change it very simple from here. Interior settings. Here you have interior settings, for example, infotainment. You can change the different settings here. Tutorial, you can have eco tips, since driving data, long driving data, blah blah blah. Here are some tips and tricks. Mirrors, by the way, you can choose when to fold the mirrors. Lower in reverse gear, you have this option to lower the mirrors. Synchronize adjustment, fold in when locking. That's great on the mirrors. Then we go to exterior. Here on the exterior you have four settings. Easy open, interior monitoring, center locking. You can activate this, keyless access. You can activate this, activate the way you want to have it. Lights, of course, you have here automatic headlights control, medium automatic headlights control in rain, convenience turning signals, coming home function, how many seconds, windows, of course, convenience opened, wipe automatic in rain, rear window wiping in reverse gear, wipers in service position, wipers and windows. And here we have the tires, tire pressure, and yeah, those are the settings. Sometimes they can be a little bit more, sometimes less, depend on the car option. Great. Going back to the main menu right here, and you will see the sound, you already see it. The settings, you didn't see it yet. Here you have the voice control, Wi-Fi, data connect, system information, copyrights and information about the system, and also units. Here you can change the units, kilometer, miles, Fahrenheit, wherever you want to have the car, you can find all those options here. Language, of course, you can change the language, time and date, screen settings and stuff like that. Going back to the home screen, and then you have the user. You can have your own user store, legal notice, and those are almost all the options. It's a very complex and nice system. To be honest, I like it very much. Also, I like very much the navigation system. I find it one of the best. You have here all the important stuff that you want to search for. It, you find it here in the navigation. The old Poi, you find it here. It's a very good navigation system. It's very reliable. It's work like a charm, to be honest, and I like it. Also, you can cancel the trip very easily, not like in other cars where you still try to find the things. But yeah, anyway, guys, I like the multimedia system. I like it very much. I think Seat and Cupra make a great job with it. Great software, amazing multimedia system. Guys, if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel if you want to see the newest videos on the market. Also, thank you very much for watching. I guess I wait you soon in the next video. Bye, guys.